Iraq banned the dollar on January 1st. So let's briefly take a look at what the dinar gurus said would happen. And then I'll teach you three things about currencies that would have told you this was a lie from the start. Over the past month, I've gotten a flurry of comments saying January 1st was going to be the date of the magical Iraqi dinar revaluation. The USD will no longer be in use starting January 1st, so an automatic increase of the dinar will happen. Before January 1st is my strong opinion. They have to do something by then because the dollar won't be accepted in Iraq after January 1st. As of January 2024, dollars won't be used, so dinar holders should finally begin to see some profits. And why did everyone think that? Because that's the false hope all the gurus were spreading.
You think January 1st today is highly possible by the 1st.
The Central Bank of Iraq, without any fear, without pulling any punches back, they flat out are telling you the beginning of the next year, your currency will have value added to it.
Is that why they keep telling the citizens that after the 1st, they will add value to their currency?
Yeah, I think January is going to be a very good month for us.
And what's new? I'm right, they're wrong. Now, if you actually care to learn about investing, here are three currency lessons you can take from this. Now, had you known any of these things, you would have known the gurus were dead wrong about their prediction. Lesson one, magnitude matters. Directionally, the logic makes sense here. Supply and demand are what drive currencies. And all else equal, this should create more demand for the dinar and less for the dollar. However, they are not actually going to fully stop using the dollar. In fact, their dollar usage is barely going to change at all. They're going to restrict its use within Iraq for things like restaurants and hotels, but almost their entire GDP is driven by selling oil, and that will still be in dollars. This is like the equivalent of saying, I'm going to stop going to other restaurants, and I'm only going to eat at McDonald's for lunch every day. Now, will that massively drive their stock price up? Well, they do make money by selling burgers. So all else equal, it's a positive. But given how small of an impact that would be to their overall burger sales, it's probably not going to impact their stock price. It's the same for Iraq banning the dollar within Iraq for most things. It will have a very limited impact on the Iraqi dinar. Magnitude matters. Lesson two, international trade requires reserves. And reserves require reliable currencies. You would have known they couldn't come close to fully banning the dollar if you'd known that no one would realistically accept the dinar for their exports to Iraq. Why not? Because when a country sells a product to another country, let's say it's wheat from Ukraine or electronics from Japan, it doesn't matter. They ideally want to sell it in their own currency. Or if not, they want to sell it in a currency that's easily convertible into their own currency or one that they can use for other purchases. So sometimes countries that trade with each other a lot can do some of that trade in each other's currencies, but only if they would feel comfortable holding that currency in reserves until they need to make another purchase. Otherwise, they'll want to use a more stable, freely convertible, widely usable currency like the US dollar. Hence why the dollar is the global reserve currency. So Iraq might be able to sell some oil to China for yuan because they need yuan for stuff they're going to purchase from China. However, China wouldn't want to sell anything to Iraq for dinars because they wouldn't want to hold the dinar in their reserves. It can't be used for anything outside of Iraq, and I doubt they trust the Iraqi government to keep it stable. Iraq can use fewer dollars and more of other stable currencies like the euro, the yuan, the yen, etc., but that would not increase the demand for the dinar. The third lesson is that the real reason they're banning the dollar in Iraq is because there's a dollar shortage. Well, that and the fact that they're trying to crack down on the black market for dollars, which finances a bunch of corruption and other illegal activity that they're trying to combat. But our lesson here is on the dollar shortage, because that is fairly common with emerging market currencies, particularly when the US is raising interest rates, AKA it gets more expensive to get dollars. Like I've explained many times in other videos, currencies are driven by supply and demand. When there's a black market rate, like there is in Iraq right now, where the currency is at a lower valuation than the official rate, it means there's a high demand for the dollar. People are willing to pay more than the official rate to get dollars. That's usually a sign that the country is having trouble maintaining confidence in the local currency, and it often leads the currency to weaken a few years down the road. The way a government maintains a currency peg is through supply and demand. If there's too little demand for their currency, they have to buy it. If there's too much demand for their currency, they have to sell it. They buy and sell it for whatever the currency is pegged to, which in this case, is dollars. So in our example here, the Iraqi dinar black market rate of over 1500, which is weaker than the official rate of 1300, tells us that there is too little demand for the dinar. So they need to buy the dinar and sell dollars to maintain the peg. Well, they can only do that as long as they have dollars to sell. Once they run out of dollar reserves, they can no longer maintain the peg and have to devalue their currency to reflect the reality that the market is already pricing in. So right now, Iraq is banning the dollar in Iraq to get their hands on as many dollars as they can. If people think they won't be able to use their dollars, They'll trade them into Iraqi state-owned banks for dinars. The government gets more dollars and can maintain the peg for a little longer. That is why they're banning dollars in Iraq, to curb illicit black market activity and stabilize the weak currency. It's not to magically revalue it upward. That was, is, and always will be impossible. Hey, thanks for watching. If you want more investment insight from me, check out the link below to my free Discord, and I'll see you in the next video.